What's up, everybody? Left Stick here. Welcome to part three of my Resident Evil Collectathon, where I'm trying to go through this game, collecting all of the antique coins and all of the bobbleheads. Last episode, we went through most of the main house, got all three dog heads, and fought Jack twice, leaving him basically just a pair of legs. I am using x-ray goggles. That's why it looks like I've got the psychostimulants on all the time. That's a perk for beating the game in less than 4 hours. This is my third playthrough. And I'm just kind of looking around. There's an antique coin there that I don't have room for. So here. In a second, I'll probably head to an item box. There's another one of the Mr. Everywhere dolls, the bobbleheads. That one's kind of hidden away. There are some that are hidden away real well, and then there are some that are pretty obvious out in the open, just like any good collectible. Antique coins are kind of the same way too, but they seem to be in more accessible places. That's probably because you use them to unlock items. The Mr. Everywhere dolls are kinda just there for a trophy. I don't know if you really get anything. There might be an unlock at the end of the game if you get all of them. I'm not quite sure. Coming up here, gonna see Granny. She kind of shows up whenever the story's progressing a little bit. She's humming some sort of song that may factor into the story eventually. I don't know. Getting that antique coin that I couldn't get earlier. Gonna pull up the stats. As it stands right now, I have 7 antique coins and half of the Mr. Everywhere dolls. So doing pretty good on all that. This game's really cool and a lot like the old Resident Evils in that you kind of learn the easiest and fastest ways to get through it. There are little tricks and little shortcuts that open up all the time. Here I am putting the last dog head in the door. Walking outside into freedom. Not really freedom, but getting out of the house. Relative freedom, we'll call it that. Up here is a secret area. Peel off this aluminum side and stuff. Go into the house. Unlock the first of 2 repair kits. Throughout the course of the game, there's a broken pistol and a broken shotgun. You can use repair kits that you find to repair them to working condition. Have a better pistol and a better shotgun if you want to take the time to search those out. See, I just destroyed another Mr. Everywhere doll. It's hiding under the trailer. I think that makes 11. So we're going to the big family trailer. Maybe Zoe's bra hanging out. It's another one of the safe rooms. You can find a box. I'm gonna go ahead and show you the Mia tape. I forgot to do it on the first session, so I recorded it later. So I just kind of edited it in. So this is the second of four tapes. First one being the footage of the Ghostbusters guys in the house.
Ethan, if you find this, I know I can't expect anything from you. Not after what happened, after what I did. But I just want you to know that wasn't me. I don't know what happened. There's so much that you need to know.
There you are! You gave us quite a scare, young lady.
This tape is Mia running from Marguerite.
Catch me again.
The wife of the Baker clan. Kind of designed to show you
over here
some upcoming stuff that you're about to do. That's what all these videotapes kind of are. This is also kind of the closest this game gets to Amnesia or Alien Isolation, where you're hiding from somebody. There are little bits and pieces of it along the way, but this is kind of like
I am sick and tired
the big
sick
section of the game.
Of your bullshit.
I need to hide.
Hide behind stuff while
I need to hide.
Why?
Marguerite is stalking around.
What have I done to deserve this except
it's really
open
kind of creepy.
My home and feed you? Don't understand you at all. This is it.
I really like this section a lot.
This house has seen
Marguerite's probably the creepiest person in the game.
Just don't understand.
Especially for someone like me.
Just don't.
We'll talk about that later. But still hiding from her. She catches you, she runs up and tapes over. It's very scripted where you can hide.
I know
but
you with Zoe on
first
fire.
Time you go through this, it's pretty intense, let me tell you.
I think I don't know what you want to do with that boy, Ethan. You to my babies and fertilize the garden with what was left.
Really don't like her babies. I don't like them at all.
We open our home. We open our hearts. And what do you do?
She loves you.
Sometimes it's kind of hard to find the invisible trigger that starts the next scripted moment.
You!
I was kind of bobbing and weaving there a
little bit. All you have to do is accept her fucking gift! We love you! Why can't you see that? Embrace us! There are known unknowns! No! You don't fucking try to escape your share of the blame! There's no way out of there, Missy! Where do you think you're going?
Stephen, please help me. Stephen, help me. No!
All right, let's talk about the Uncanny Valley for a little bit. Marguerite's a real good example of what I was saying earlier about having character models that just, for some reason, don't act right. Her mouth was definitely not moving in sync with the words that are coming out of her mouth. Really just adds to the creepiness of her. Jack, to a certain extent, had that. It wasn't that bad. And not many of the other people have that as bad as Marguerite does. But, like, every time she opens her mouth or moves, she's stiff and wooden and just doesn't move quite right. And it's terrifying. I think that's one thing that this game does really right, is that sense of unease and the kind of the atmosphere that just drips over everything in here. And that was kind of what, like, Resident Evil 1 and 2 made them so good, was the atmosphere.
What did they do to you, Mia?
And we're back to the first playthrough. If I would have done it all over again, I would have not put the banner. Well, as you can see, I learned my lesson. Here, you can see what the antique coins actually do. So this first birdcage takes 3 coins. You get some steroids to make your health better. Make your max HP permanently bigger. You do have to have a slot to pick it up, though. And then the second one is 5, and it gives you a stabilizer. And the stabilizer makes your reload speed permanently faster. If I had to choose between the two, I would much rather have steroids, because I think the reload speed is pretty good as it stands. So there's the broken handgun I was talking about earlier, which you can fix up with the repair kit.
You made it. You're the first I've ever seen make it this far.
So what is it you need me to do? Is it going to help me get out of here?
Yes. Now listen carefully, Ethan. My family and I, our bodies are contaminated. I can't leave the property unless I get it out. And the same goes for Mia.
Is there a way to get it out?
We need the serum. It should clear whatever this stuff is out of the body. As long as you're not too far gone.
All right. So where is it?
If I knew where one was, I'd already be long gone. But I have a feeling my mother has hidden some inside the old house somewhere.
So if we get this thing, I can help Mia and we can get out of here?
Right. And so can I. The old house is near the water. You can't miss it.
All right.
I just hope you can handle my mother.
Your mother?
Be careful. They'll be looking for you.
So we're being intentionally vague. Not really warning you about her mother too much. Up the repair kit. Here, I'm gonna combine it with the broken handgun to get another handgun. I'm probably gonna just drop in an item box because I have an even better handgun than that. So this is, I guess, the first of the treasure photos. Not available until you find the treasure photo. But gave me another steroid, so I have even more health now. The graphics in this game. I think they have to be this good to make a first-person Resident Evil viable. You just layer everything with such a layer of disgusting grime and, I guess, mold and that kind of stuff. Make it look really good. You know, in a nasty kind of way. But the few times that Resident Evil's tried to do a first-person thing before, I think it's fallen flat. Just partially because Capcom isn't the best at their offshoot Resident Evil games being any good. There are a few. But having, I don't know, having the technology available to make an atmospheric Resident Evil game helps a lot. As you can see, I just picked up an antique coin over on the table. Gave me enough to get the stabilizer. So 2 out of 3 cages down. 1 to go. That third one gives you the Magnum. Staple of Resident Evil games, but you need 9 coins to open that one. So to open all 3 is 17 coins, and there are 18 coins in the game. So I don't know what that last coin is for, what the point of it is. Okay, so this is the creepy crawly section of the game. I know it's a horror trope, but I really don't like skinning insects. Pretty much the main antagonist of this area, not counting Marguerite, who controls the bugs. So I really get a crawling, but healing all over my skin when I play this part. Like I said, this is my third time through, and I'm still like, ugh. I hate him so much. There was both another bobblehead and another
Ethan?
Antique coin.
Ethan!
So, here's Mia on the other side of this, wanting to talk to me.
Bullshit, Mia. I want some answers.
I know, you're right, and I always wanted to tell you, but I can only remember a little, and the rest is just gone.
Daddy, right? You mind if I borrow Mommy for a little bit? Why don't you stand there? Do something!
Ethan, help!
Damn it.
Alright, so looking, I have 11 Mr. Everywhere dolls. And 9 antique coins found. Pretty sure the Mr. Everywhere dolls don't have to be found all in one playthrough. Just keep track of the new ones you destroy.
Stay the fuck out!
Yeah, Marguerite's mouth movements not necessarily syncing up to the sounds coming out of her mouth. Hope nobody has arachnophobia. Spiders jumping at the screen. These wasps are huge. Luckily, you tend to be able to sneak up on them. Hit them before they start flying, because they're super annoying if they start flying at you. Just kind of hover. Oh, here we go. Like this. Kind of hover in your vision so you can find an opening to cut them up. It's a waste of ammo if you use ammo on them. See me cutting all these nests with the circular saw. I would not recommend doing that on your first playthrough until you get this weapon I'm about to get. It's a waste of bullets, and your knife is really not up to the task. You'll just get stung and stung and stung until you die. So this is the backpack. Gives you another 4 places you can store items. The way they deal out these backpacks, kind of well done. It's like as soon as you start getting upset with how little storage you have, there's always a backpack around the corner. So as you see, I also got another Mr. Everywhere doll. That one was kind of visible, kind of not. I don't know how Marguerite saw me in this room. It's supposed to be a safe room. I don't know if she really saw me or the game just tried to make it seem like she saw me. I'm gonna guess that second one. We'll just say it was a glitch. So here, that's the burner grip. Gotta get 2 items together to get the burner. I'll get the other one here in a little bit. So I forgot that statue because I didn't have enough space in my inventory. So you can't fight Marguerite off. It's not as easy as it was with Jack. earlier, but you do get a achievement for fighting her off. It's one of the hidden achievements. If you fight Marguerite off, makes a couple segments up here a little easier, because she just kind of patrols that hallway and the living room area, so you don't really necessarily have to hide from her. So if you want to waste the ammo, sure, go ahead. Or if you want to try to do it, it's not easy though. Cool thing with these spiders and all the wasps and stuff is they do leave sting marks on you. Just like they probably would in the real world. This is where you get the burner nozzle. If you mix that with the handle, then you get the new weapon. Which I should do right here. Yeah, see. For all intents and purposes, just a flamethrower. Guess it kind of works on the principle of, like, the aerosol cans and a flame. This section in the old house, I don't think I could do it in VR. I'm obviously not playing it in VR right now, but I think it would give me a heart attack. Just all those wasps and stuff flying in my face. I really don't want to think about it too much. So as you can see, this section is a lot like Mia's tape. Do the same puzzle to get to the same room here in a second.
Fuck.
All these, like, millipede, centipede things.
Jesus, fuck!
They're pretty creepy. They also kind of don't move the way you would expect them to move in real life. Kind of almost herky-jerky, stop-motion kind of movement. So this is the crawl space where Mia's tape ended. Of course, obviously I'm not gonna end the same place as her tape did. But basically that was to show you that there's a crank under there. Another one of the Resident Evil tropes. Always a crank. Always animal keys of some sort. Always really weird puzzles that no one would ever really have in their house. I don't think flying enemies in any game have ever been a good idea. They're always so small and hard to hit. Just overall annoying. Always seem like they can move faster than you can move. I will say this though, those wasps hit hard. Crank opens up a shortcut. I guess that's the first thing it opens. You're gonna use that crank over and over and over. Got another antique coin, and in this box, get our second of three animal keys. Go ahead and discard those because I've got the X-ray vision. Yeah. Alright, so we're gonna go up here and try to use the crow key.
I told you to stay out of here!
Here's Marguerite. She told us. You should have listened to this. This is, for all intents and purposes, the same kind of boss fight that Jack was for a while.
Bless your heart.
Kind of shoot her till she dies. While she's throwing down bugs and stuff.
Push
the flamethrower here, because she sends down those giant hordes of stuff. Just kind of burns them away real quick. Marguerite goes down. It's covered in this goo stuff. So without further ado, I think you can read this and then use the crow key. See what Marguerite was hiding. Sort of fetus in a box. Tells you how to make the serum.
Well,
so Zoe's gonna
did he find a serum?
Tell you
I just
you
got
to
done
get
dealing
stuff.
With your mom and her fucking bugs. Wish you could have warned me.
Sorry about that. What about the serum?
I haven't found any. But I did find out we need to make one. A D-series head and an arm. This can't be right.
A head? I think I have that around here somewhere.
You do?
I don't know about the arm, though. Have you searched the whole house?
No, not yet. I still need to check the second floor here.
All right. Check it out. Meet me at the trailer if you find it.
I really don't know what that is. Just some creepy stuff up here. I would almost say like a mummified rat something. I don't know. There's another Mr. Everywhere doll. We gotta find some way to make that thing level, balanced out. Now, if there's a lantern hanging from one side, what do you think you want to hang on the other side? That's right, another lantern. Marguerite with her big arm, big long bug arms. I guess we gotta chase her.
What the fuck? That's special.
Another treasure photo. That one shows a toilet with a whole bunch of cigarettes around it. So, gotta look for that one too. So that's unlocking the door that was locked from the other side earlier by the trailer. Maybe we can get from there to the greenhouse pretty quick. Don't have to do all that backtracking. So that's about the end of part 3 of my Resident Evil collect-a-thon. Hopefully there'll be less time between part 3 and part 4 as there was between part 2 and part 3. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe for more gameplay videos. As always, I'm Left Stick, and I will see you guys on the flip side.